Thank you, Andrew. Good afternoon. So I don't like podiums. I really like to always walk around the room. Some of you from the senior staff of athletics, you know that I kind of treat it like a game show. Podiums kind of make me feel a little stiff, but I'll try and behave myself today. Okay. First of all, I wanted to thank a few people who were involved with the process that we've just gone through. I would argue the historic process that we've just gone through. But before doing that, I wanted to extend my deepest appreciation to Matt Robinson, who is the interim AD for the department. He has led the department for a little over 4 months now and has done some great things with the department. So Matt, thank you very much. As you all know, we have been pretty busy for the last couple of weeks. Some of us have been doing a lot of reading. We had a little over 95 applicants for this position. And we spent some time last week trying to narrow that number of 95 down to a manageable number where we could all sit down and begin to assess whether or not we've, from that 95, we had some folks who we thought would be able to come to the University of Delaware and take us to places that we really feel we would like to go, need to go, and want to go. We had a search committee that was some 14 members, and I won't name all of them now, but you'll probably get their names later. We had faculty, staff, students, alumni. We also had trustees involved in the process. And I dare say it was a great, great, great experience for me and hopefully for my colleagues who also served on that committee. We had a lot of good time. We had a lot of good time. We also had a lot of opportunity to talk about the University of Delaware with respect to its student athletes, with respect to its students, and with respect to where we want to be as an athletic institution and as an academic institution. And we think that the decisions that we eventually presented to Dr. Dennis Asanas absolutely positioned us to turn out in the best place in the future. So with that, I'd like to introduce Dr. Dennis Asanas, who is our incoming president, who has a few words for you.
Good afternoon, everybody. First of all, let me just say that my wife, Eleni, and I can't wait to come here. You know, June 6th is our official start date here, and we are really, really pleased to be a member of the Blue Hen family. So now I want to add my own personal thanks before we start the process to Alan Brangman, Sue Groff, who is there, Carol Henderson, all the other members of the search committee, John Cochran, the chair of the board of trustees, everybody else, Jeff Garland, who has contributed, and also to the people who interviewed the finalists, the three finalists that we have. I would want, deep from my heart, to extend my thanks to Matt Robinson for doing a fantastic job during this transition period. You really led the department to a stable place, and we will thank you forever for that. Thank you, Matt. And we'll continue to work with you. I know you'll help us in many, many ways to bring the Olympic ideals to this campus. And now, I know you can't wait, so the big announcement. It's my absolute pleasure and delight to share with you that we have selected our new Director of Athletics and Recreation Services for the University of Delaware. And it is Chrissi Rawak. Chrissi is sitting right there. She is the current Senior Executive Associate Director of Athletics at the University of Michigan, a program which is storied with a tremendous tradition, not only in its athletics, but also in its academics, and this is what we stand for. She has an impressive leadership record and a lifetime commitment to the important role of athletics in higher education, and also to inclusive excellence. Those are both of those commitments that we share. and we treasure. I believe that athletics is an integral part of the university mission. It's the front porch of our university. It is connecting us with our alumni and the world. It's connecting us with our prospective students, their parents, and the broader community. Athletics builds pride, enhances our master brand, and manifests the spirit of our great university. So that's why athletics is so important, so strategic, and be a core part of all the efforts that we have moving forward as we continue to build excellence in our great university. So let me tell you now a little bit about Chrissi. She's an outstanding leader with a long history in both athletics as well as development and alumni relationships, and a true commitment to the student-athlete experience. As a senior administrator, she has been making things happen at the University of Michigan for more than a dozen years. She has held a couple of different roles, critical roles, during that time. Most recently, as the Executive Senior Associate Athletics Director of Intercollegiate Athletics, she oversees external relations and strategic initiatives, fundraising, ticket sales, brand management, external communications, marketing, community relations, digital and social media, corporate sponsorships, game day experience, among other many things. With her team, and I wonder if she gets any sleep ever, with her team, she launched the first comprehensive athletics fundraising campaign at the University of Michigan, which raised so far, in the last 5 years, $300 million, yes, $300 million, including one $100 million transformational gift from Stephen Ross. And that's fantastic. The even more fantastic part is Stephen Ross gave $100 million to academics and $100 million to athletics. That's what we aspire for here at the University of Delaware. Before her current position, she spent 7 years in the University of Michigan's Office of University Development, where she was the Assistant Vice President of Talent Management and Development Operations. And talent management is so critical in developing our student athletes, mentoring our coaches, in building great athletics departments. From 1998 to 2004, she worked in alumni relations and development at Northwestern University. Again, a wonderful thing which really connects the university with the alumni. In addition to the breadth of her experience on the administrative side, she brings her own personal experience as a student athlete. Chrissi has been a member of the University of Michigan's swimming team for a while. She's been a competitive athlete from 1988 to 92. And during her senior year, she was the president of the University of Michigan student government. For those of you who are students, this is a big deal. It's like 45,000 students who elected Chrissi to be their leader. After her competitive swimming career, she transitioned into coaching immediately. She was an assistant coach of the swimming team, so she knows something about coaching and also something about athletics and student athletes and their needs. And she served in that role from 1992 to 1997. As you can see, she has a lot of impressive credentials. Let me tell you in the summary what I believe that Chrissi brings to the table. She brings to us her enthusiasm, her hard work ethic, her loyalty to the university that she works. She has only worked in two universities all her life. And now a third for the rest of your life. She brings to us a true passion for athletics. The people in the search committee said that she's an academic citizen, a university citizen. She's somebody who builds bridges and not walls. She's somebody who cuts across. She's somebody who includes people, works with people, and sees connectivities and is cross-functional. All those things, you know, because if we want to succeed in academics, we've got to bring in their student life and our financial planning and, of course, the academics and everything else in the university. And needless to say, development, because we can use another dollar or two for our athletics programs. So all of those are very, very important. She's coming to Delaware in a way that is sort of a homecoming. Chrissi grew up in the Philadelphia area, and we really believe that Philadelphia is part of the greater Delaware area. So in so many ways, this is wonderful. Her husband was also on the gymnastics team at the University of Michigan. And again, that's really fantastic. They have a great partnership, three joint ventures, three wonderful children, a son, who I hope will be a blue hen very soon, and two daughters. So I'm in recruiting mode immediately, all the time. So I'm really, really delighted to have Chrissi with us, and she really looks forward to work with you and for you to build wonderful programs. We stand for excellence in academics and athletics. Thank you very much, Chrissi.
Wow. Thank you so much, President Asanas, for those kind words, and more importantly, for the opportunity to join the Delaware family. It's truly an honor. I want to thank the search committee for their very important role in this process. I am truly humbled and honored to be entrusted with the leadership of this department, and I will do all I can to make the Blue Hens here in Delaware and across the world proud every day. I want to acknowledge, like Dennis did and President Asanas and Alan did, Matt Robinson. I had the opportunity actually to spend some time with him earlier today, and it was an honor and a privilege to sit with him, and can only say thank you, like others have, for all the work that you've done I also want to take a moment and thank the wonderful people of the University of Michigan. I've had a 20-year relationship with this unbelievable university as a student athlete, as a coach, as an athletics and a university administrator. And the relationships that I have built there are phenomenal, and I couldn't have asked for a better experience. Because of school and travel schedules, my husband Glenn, who I think is watching, hi honey, and my children Blake and Evelyn and Grace could not be with me today, but I owe them everything. Their love and support has allowed me to be who I am. And their continuous encouragement has given me the opportunity to be with you today. And I don't take that for granted. I know they can't wait to be Blue Hens. As a matter of fact, when I told my son I was interviewing, he said, "Mom, we could be Blue Hens." I said, "Yes, they have the winged helmet." I said, "Yes, good, that's good." But I know that they're going to look forward to being a part of this community and really being members of this Blue Hen family. I also want to thank my parents, Peyton and Rawak. I grew up, as the president said, 75 miles away from this community. I actually competed twice in the natatorium, made my first junior national cut, so it was a very special place for me. But these two people have instilled in me, at a very early age, the importance of education, work ethic, and athletics. My experience as a student athlete in high school and college have shaped me, and it's the reason I am who I am today. The coaches and the mentors and the teachers who helped me reach my potential in all the endeavors inspired me to do what I can do for others. College athletics should be about the student athlete. It is what we will wake up every day working hard to do together to create the very best all-around experiences for our student athletes, without question. In addition, the responsibilities of overseeing the recreation and club programs is also equally as important. And the experience of the health of all of our students, faculty, and staff, we will make that a priority as well. Over the coming days, weeks, and months, I will be taking the time to learn a great deal about this world-class institution and the men and women who love it so passionately. It has come through very clearly, which I love. Passion is important. I will travel through the state from Newcastle County on down to Kent and Sussex, meeting the people who make this state great. Though I have a lot to learn and listening to do, I can without a doubt tell you that we will win. We will win championships. We will graduate our student athletes. We will serve the campus and the community, and we will do all of it with integrity and class. There are challenges at Delaware, for sure, and the issues and the landscape within intercollegiate athletics will continue to change. But together, we can and will accomplish great things. I have no doubt about that. The department is not about one person, It is not about one coach, one team, or even one era. It is about those who came before us, those who are here now, and those who will come along after we are gone. I believe in leaving things better than you found them, and I believe that we have a responsibility to all the people that love this university. In the coming weeks, I hope to be able to spend time with each and every one of you, but I will let you know that my first charge, hopefully no surprise, is to find a fantastic men's basketball coach. And that process for me starts today. I owe it to the young men in our basketball program whom I met with a few hours ago, which was an honor and a privilege to hear what they're looking for in this person that's going to lead them. And I promise them, and I promise all of you, that I will work aggressively but comprehensively to find them and this great university the very best head coach. Thank you all for coming Friday afternoon. And I know we will have many more opportunities to meet, and this is just simply a great day to be a Blue Hen. Thank you.
With that, we'll open up for questions from the press.
Do you want us to ask Dr. Sonnes questions first, or does it matter?
We can do either or. You can do them at the, ask your question and then the appropriate person will come up with me.
Dr. Sonnes, I would ask you first. Kevin Trestany from the News Journal.
Pleased to meet you.
Nice to see you. Did you know Chrissi well at Michigan when you in the years that you were there?
I did not.
Okay. Does the fact that you have a Michigan background, and obviously she has a strong Michigan background, does that kind of, you know, give you some comfort, you know, in knowing her and knowing what she could possibly do?
Let me first say, Kevin, that I was looking for the best person on earth to take the athletics program here to the next level. If the person came from the University of Michigan or another great university like University of Michigan, to me, it was all about the person and the fit and the values that they would bring to the table. I'm comfortable that she's coming from the University of Michigan because we share very similar values about academics and athletics and their coexistence in a great university. But there's several other universities I can name in the AUs that have similar values.
When we talked to you when your hiring was announced, we didn't really get a chance to ask you about your vision for athletics. What is your vision for athletics?
Thank you for the opportunity. My vision for athletics are their core to the university, an integral part of our strategic plan, not an appendix. It's all about the success of the student athletes, as Chrissi is saying. So our vision is that athletics, academics, and developmental efforts all work together in the great university community, which is nourished by our alumni and our friends and the broader Delaware society. So we absolutely believe in the values of athletics and what they teach our students, and vice versa, what we teach our student athletes.
Why was it important for you to hire an athletic director for a basketball coach?
My job here is to hire a great senior management team. Chrissi is going to be a member of my senior management team. She will have a seat at the table, along with all the other academic leaders, the student life leaders, the financial leaders of the university, development leaders, public safety leaders, communication leaders, and so on. She needs to form her own team. She needs to hire her own coaches. She needs to mentor her coaches, lead them to success, and hold them accountable. She's going to be the one who hires the basketball coach. And this is a great opportunity, and I believe this is what made so attractive this position to phenomenal candidates for the athletics director job, because let's face it, this is a major, major opportunity. Let me just say that I see the basketball program as a wonderful opportunity for the University of Delaware. I can see this as being one of the jewels on our athletics crowns. There is no reason why within 4 years we couldn't be beating teams like Villanova and some other small teams like that. We're going to commit to it.
From a practical standpoint of building this athletics program, how important was it to get an athletic director who had a strong development and fundraising background?
It was one of the qualities we were looking for, but again, if you look at Chrissi's background, she's the complete package because she not only knows about fundraising, but she knows about alumni relationships. She knows about the power of communication. She knows about crisis management. She was a student athlete. She was a coach. She knows how to pick talent. She knows how to hire people. She knows how to fire people. These are the kinds of things that I was looking for, to revenue generate, the whole package. Again, we've considered many, many important and great people, and I know all of them will become athletics directors somewhere in this country. At this moment in time, Chrissi is the absolute best fit with the university's vision.
Sean Green with WDEL, you say take the athletic program to the next level. What do you define as the next level?
Thank you for this great question. I was looking for this opportunity. So we need to be strategic about everything we do. That means, among other things, we are constantly thinking about the right alignment for us, which conference we play, which are the peer schools, academically and athletically. I envision and dream about some fantastic rivalries that will bring the people to the stadiums, to the arenas, that will celebrate those relationships and friendships and competition for life. So everything is open right now. We're going to consider with the athletics director where we want to be and define where we want to be. But I have to tell you, before we approach who are the peers, where do we want to be? What is the next level for us? The first thing we need to do is to be the best within CAA. That's why I've hired the best athletics director within the CAA, so that we can be there.
Any other questions? Okay. With that,
thank you.
Do you have one more question?
For Chrissi.
Oh, I'm sorry. Go ahead.
How difficult is it to step in and have to immediately deal with the men's basketball head coaching situation? How quickly do you think you can resolve that at higher level?
Yeah. Not difficult at all, actually, to be honest. I'm excited about the opportunity. There's actually been a lot of some good work that's already been done by the search firm, and Matt has also been a part of that process. And I'm jumping in tomorrow morning. I've obviously had conversations today, as I said, but I'm not worried. We're going to find the best head coach for this university.
Chrissi, hi, Kevin Tressley.
Hi, Kevin. How are you?
Great.
Good.
Welcome to Delaware.
Thank you.
We're a great place.
Thank you.
You know, as Dr. Son has said, I mean, you know, you've got a lot of different backgrounds, mm-hmm. most of them in development. You know, obviously, you're now stepping into a position where you have to wear many, many hats. Mm-hmm. Is that going to be an adjustment for you, and how do you adjust to that? Are do you feel like that's something, you know, that you're ready for at this stage of your career in athletic administration?
Yeah, I appreciate that. Absolutely, I feel like I'm ready for it. Part of how I achieve the ability to do that is I have really smart people around the table, and I empower them to do their jobs. And if I've got the best talent around the table, which I believe I do, then we're going to be fine, and I'll be fine. And it gives me the opportunity to do what I need to do for this university, for our student athletes, for our coaches. But it really is about the talent around the table. I mean, our business is people.
In terms of development, people have always looked at Delaware as a place where there's lots of untapped mm-hmm. potential. Mm-hmm. And there are some needs here that have long been unmet, mm-hmm. Particularly in terms of upgrades at the football stadium. Mm-hmm. Is that something that may have come up at all during your discussions in route to getting the position?
Yeah, so obviously, as the president mentioned, I mean, fundraising is important. It is an opportunity that we have control over, right? We did not speak about specifics of facilities or any of those things, but fundamentally, I understand it's important in Michigan. It's important everywhere, especially based on, you know, what's happening with college athletics as a whole. And I'm looking forward to understanding it more here at the University of Delaware. Monica, who is a phenomenal fundraiser, I know her and her team a bit, and she's done some terrific work. And we're going to be great partners, and we're going to figure out what we need to be doing to be able to help not only the University of Delaware raise athletics raise money, but academics. As the president shared, that is a commitment. I'm a university citizen, and there's no question I want what's best for the athletic program, but I know fundamentally usually what's best for athletics will be best for academics, and we won't compromise on that. So.
Just piggybacking on this question. Once you get past the basketball mm-hmm. decision, decision. As you're getting the lay of the land, are there certain things you are looking for or specifically examining as you try to set your priorities?
Yeah, so I'm really here to listen and learn, and then I can be able to understand that and answer that question. I mean, as I mentioned in my comments, the next couple of months are really going to be about talking and listening and understanding and asking questions, and obviously sitting with the president and that leadership team to really be able to do the best we can and put our best foot forward for athletics.
Are there some things you know from your experience that you have to look at closely to build that priority?
Well, I mean, I think it's about the people. I think it's about the academic experiences of our student athletes. It's about, you know, how are we doing from a fundraising perspective? I mean, there are fundamentals about that, but there isn't anything in particular because it's a pretty complex puzzle, right? And I don't want to misstep. I want to really come in and understand and be sure I'm educated by all of our constituents that care. Thank goodness they care. So I'm looking forward to those conversations that will help me formulate what a better answer for you in a few months.
Chrissi, one of the big issues facing college sports nowadays is cost of attendance. Mm-hmm. So far, Delaware has decided that's not something it wants to do. Have you been able to, you were hired an hour ago.
I was. Thank you.
That's, you know, where is that something that's going to have to be a big focus for this university in terms of, what other schools in the conference are doing and so forth?
Yeah, I feel like I don't know enough yet to have that to make any kind of determination. I mean, I think that, as the president said, we want to do everything we can do to be competitive.
Right.
And what that means for us, I don't know yet. So
maybe if I can add to this, the cost of attendance for all our students, not just our student athletes, as I've said before when I was elected, is a big deal for us, for me, for the Board of Trustees, everybody in the administration. We want to manage the costs in education. And of course, because of that, and because of our commitment in the athletics with the limited resources that we have, this is why it's so important to engage in the fundraising efforts and the revenue generation efforts. And, you know, we're not going to try to do the growth of our athletics on the back of our students, you know, more fees and more tuition increases. But I think we can do it. There's tremendous potential. We have loyal alumni. I hope you can help us to bring all those alumni back to the stadiums. That's what we need. Fill them up.
All right. Sir?
FCS football, you know, people kind of wonder about the future of FCS football, and while the helmets look the same, there's a lot of differences.
Sure.
Do you have much of a feeling yet for where that might be going, and do you kind of see that, as Dr. Hassan's kind of alluded to, do you see the future of this level of football as kind of being one of the big issues you'll have to deal with in coordination with your athletic team in the next few years?
Mm-hmm. I think there's lots of things I'm going to have to deal with. This may be one of them. Again, you know, I'm coming in to learn, to listen, to ask questions, and to make sure that we're putting ourselves in the best position to win in the classroom and on the field and in the community. Go for it.
I'll just simply add that it's not just the FCS, the FBS as well. As we're talking constantly about conference realignment, and as some of the FBS schools might be dropping down in the FCS, that opportunity to redefine the levels, you asked me a question about the level, I think we are going to take a leadership role, and I'm going to work with other presidents to identify who our peers are and what is the right competition for us. We do want to win, but we want to be with peers who share the same academic values as the University of Delaware.
Any other questions? All right.
Thank you.
Thank you.